Okay, let's continue our session. And now our next speaker, Sergiy Maksymenko from Institute of Mathematics of National Academy of Science of Ukraine, Kyiv. And this title on the square of diffeomorphism of surfaces.
Thank you very much. Actually, I am usually suffering of absence of blackboard. Therefore, I made my slides and I will try to draw on them. So I use some other program, and maybe you can see. What? Yes, you see, yes, something. Good. So the title of my talk is about squares of diffeomorphisms of surfaces. This is a joint work with Irina Kuznetsova, my postgraduate student. And let me start. Okay, so let me first recall very well-known geometric effect. Consider the group of symmetries of the right n polygon. For example, the right something like this. This group has it is called dihedral group, and it has the following representation. The following presentation. So it has two generators, S and R. S is a symmetry. For example, S can do the following thing. It is just mirror symmetry with respect to some line. For example, with respect to this line, not some line, but line which passes through the center of this polygon and through opposite vertices or needles of the opposite edges. In the case if it has even number of edges, and in this case, for example, we can take, for instance, this one S. This will be S. And another generator is R. Here, so sorry, he is S. Well, and he is R. S here. And R is the rotation. And here R is also rotation. And this, so we know this presentation. It has very special features that the product of rotation and the mirror symmetry, they can be switched. But in this case, the rotation should be made in opposite direction. And this leads to the following effect, that first of all, every element of this group can be written as a pair of elements S and R. So it will be can be written in this form, S to the power A, R to the power B, and A from 0 to 1 and B from 0 to n minus 1. And another very essential feature is that every element of this form where S is presented has an order 2. So if you go to the power 2, then we get the identity. And this means that every element of this form is just a mirror symmetry. More general effect, the same holds in the orthogonal group. So if you take orthogonal group, the group of orthogonal matrices, then topologically it is just two circles, one circle and another circle. This is the first and this is the second. And the groups of this kind, it is a subgroup and it is called SO2. And this set of matrices is not a group, but it is an adjacent class of SO2. And they also have the same property. So every element of this form has order 2. So if we just even analytically, if we multiply this matrix by itself, then we will get the identity. On the other hand, in general, if you have a diffeomorphism of a circle, arbitrary diffeomorphism of a circle, which reverses orientation, then it is not in general its square. So if H is a diffeomorphism from S1 to S1 and it reverses orientation, then H square is not equal to the identity. So this effect is very special for the, so we need to preserve some, so there is some rigidity in this effect. And my aim, the aim of this talk is to present a certain kind of homotopical and foliated analog of this effect. So the rigidity is presented, but it is presented in some homotopical sense. And now I will try to explain what actually happens. So let me start from considering the following things. Let M be a compact surface. I will draw a picture. So I have a surface and I will consider functions on this surface. For example, this is a function, this is a torus. You see two critical points, several number of critical points. Yes, and this is my function. And the group of diffeomorphisms acts on the space of smooth functions by this formula. And this means that if we have my surface, how to imagine this action? Let me draw maybe here. So I take a function, for instance, consider this function on a disk. So I take a function whose level sets are of this form. So it looks like this. So geometrically, if you draw a graph of this function, maybe it may have this form. And this function to the real line. So here we have level sets of this function. Here two critical points, it's another critical points, and so on. Then if you have this is function F, if you have a diffeomorphism H, that what it essentially changes this picture. So for example, this figure 8 maybe goes to something like this, okay, it's all good. So it may essentially change the general picture. So, but now we have another function because every diffeomorphism, it sends this figure eight to this line, to this figure eight. And here we have a foliation by some different kind of of curves, but every curve remember the value of the function. So if this function has value say zero, then we can construct here another function which takes on these curves takes the values from that come from by h from this picture. So I just take a composition h minus one, or maybe I can just switch to another direction as it is written in the slides. So I take h and this will be f in composition. So this is the action. This is a description of this action of the group of diffeomorphism on this space of function. Well, and now if we have this action, then the question is what about stabilizers? So how to imagine diffeomorphisms preserving a given function? And if we go back to this picture, then we see what are diffeomorphisms which preserve this function. If it preserves the function, then it must preserve every level set as a set. So for example, in this situation, diffeomorphism which preserves this function, it can exchange this picture. So it can change these points, and actually it is like a twist. Well, but it can be done only if these points are at the same level set and they smoothly equivalent. So this means that, for instance, this point can be degenerated and this non-degenerated, then we cannot switch them. So sometimes diffeomorphisms can also exchange connected components of level sets and preserve the function. Well, and I will be considering the following class of functions. It is described here, and this class of functions is the following. So I consider the functions which takes constant value at each boundary component. So this was at the previous slide. So for instance, this could be something like this. So it is essential feature of these functions. And another which says about local properties of the functions. Namely, local properties are the following. So at every critical point, there is a local representation of my function. So in some local coordinates at every critical point, my function is a homogeneous polynomial without multiple factors. What does it mean? Let me explain this in more detail. So for example, suppose we have a function f x y x equals x squared minus y square or x square plus y square. Then this is a homogeneous polynomial without multiple factors because it can be written as, yes. And this means that this class contains the space of all Morse functions on the surface. So it is, in fact, it is very general and a big class, and it contains open and everywhere dense subset of functions, of course, satisfying this condition, because this condition is the first condition is not generic, but this condition, so non-degeneracy condition is generic, and therefore, Morse satisfying this condition, say A and say B. And so more satisfying additional condition. No, let me say, put here boundary. Right? And here I put also boundary. This means Morse functions taking constant values and boundary components. Well, another, what is the property about absence of multiple factors? Let me recall that if you have arbitrary homogeneous polynomial in two variables, for instance, suppose the degree of f equals, say, 4, for example, that it has, let me consider example, x4 plus 3x square y square plus xy square minus xy4, for example, then it every such polynomial is can be represented as a product of linear and linear factors and quadratic factors, which quadratic and non-reducible quadratic factors, because we can just this is a trivial consequence of a well-known statement about which is called the principle theorem of algebra, that every polynomial over a real line is represented as a product of linear factors and quadratic factors. Yeah, because we can just divide all these, for example, by y to the power 4, and we will get a polynomial of the power of just a polynomial in one variable x by y. Well, and then we split it into the product of factors and we get the result. So the question, the statement that there is no linear, for example, if you have linear factors, if you write x minus 3y, x plus 2y, x minus y, x, for instance, then every such line, if you want to understand what are the level sets of my function, then each of these factors gives you, for instance, you consider the zero set of the inverse image f, and we consider f of 0. Then we will get each zeros of each of these multiples. So we have several lines. And then level sets are go as no, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, one more. I need one more, something like that. So level sets will have this form. And absence of powers, for instance, if I have here square, this means that if I take the derivative, then this line, the zeros of this line consists of critical points, because if you take a derivative, then the derivative will have this multiple, and the absence of multiple factors actually means that the critical point is always isolated. That was the principal feature of this class of polynomials. Well, let me go further. And now what I'm interested in the space of, in the group of diffeomorphisms which preserve my function. So once again, consider that example. I will consider this example. This is function on a disk. Well, yeah. And I will consider diffeomorphisms which preserve my function. So belonging to the stabilizer. He is F. Well, and then the stabilizer can be, I will switch to the case when, here should be disk. Well, switch to the case when my manifold is a two-dimensional disk. Then there are diffeomorphisms which preserve orientation and which reverse orientation. And actually we have a natural homomorphism from the stabilizer, so the group of diffeomorphism preserving my function, to the Z2, associating to every H, zero if H preserves orientation, and one if it reverses orientation. The kernel of this diffeomorphism will be denoted by S plus F, and this is the group of diffeomorphism preserving orientation, and the another adjacent class is will be denoted by S minus of F. It is, so we have this decomposition. And the principal result, which is actually, which is a generalization of that effect about elements changing orientation and having degree two in the orthogonal group and in the dihedral group, is the following statement. So suppose let D be a two-dimensional disk, F is a function of that class, and suppose there exists a diffeomorphism which reverse orientation and preserve my function. It is not always true that such diffeomorphism exists. For example, I will draw another picture. Suppose we have a function whose level sets is of the following form. Let me draw here something like this, this. And this. So here we have, it is maybe not good written, but let me just increase this thing. Let me draw once again, just to have more better. So here one, and here I make one, and one, and one. What? No, sorry. I want this one. What? So it has, if you look, this is a Morse function, having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 critical points, and if you, and 1, 2, 3, 4 saddles, but you see that, you can see that it cannot, there is no diffeomorphisms which reverse orientation and preserves this function. All other level sets are just concentric curves. For example, diffeomorphism of this kind, if we have a function, for instance, say of this form, then we have diffeomorphisms which are symmetric with respect to this line, for example, with respect to this line. If I put something here, for instance, I add more critical point, then in fact, I can add it here. This is the same topologically. And again, I have diffeomorphism which reverse orientation and preserve my function, which is just a symmetry with respect to this line, horizontal line, or with respect to this line. Maybe not so, this is geometry. If this is a rigid body, that of course, there is no symmetry, but actually topologically, we can see that this thing is topologically symmetrical with respect to some line of this form. If I put more, for example, one more critical point, then again, these things will be symmetric with respect to this line, but not with respect to line of this kind. And now what I did here, I add one more saddle inside. And now if in this picture, you could see that there is no symmetries of this kind. So not always diffeomorphism, the group of diffeomorphism preserving function has diffeomorphism which reverse orientation. So not always this homomorphism is surjective. And if it is not surjective, then of course it's this group coincides with this group. And then the statement is of this form, which states the following. Suppose this set is not non-trivial. So then for every diffeomorphism from here, there exists another diffeomorphism which also change orientation and which preserves the function, which coincide with the previous diffeomorphism in the neighborhood of the boundary and has this property. So its square belongs to the identity path component of this of the stabilizer. So in the homotopical sense, this element is trivial. I will discuss in 1 minute this group. And what is the consequence of this result? The following. So the map, the orientation homomorphism, which I wrote before, has this kernel. If this homomorphism is non-trivial, then it admits a section. So this group consists of two elements, 0, 1. And what I do, I associate 0, 1 to identity and that element G, this G from this theorem. And this map is a homomorphism because it has order 2 in the pi 0 of the stabilizer. And actually this implies the certain algebraic result about this group of the pi 0 of the stabilizer. This group is a group of isotopic classes of diffeomorphism preserving the function. So it is an analog of a mapping class group. And the statement that this group in this case is always a semi-direct product, because if this map has a section, then we have the structure of certain structure of semi-direct product, because there are maybe many semi-direct products of one group with another group. And in fact, this group is structure of this group is completely understandable. So I will try to explain how it can be, why it is, its algebraic structure. And we now know that in order to understand this group, so we completely understand now the structure, algebraic structure of this group for the stabilizer of the functions on a two-dimensional disk. Now let me, maybe I will skip this description, but just few words, how to imagine what is the algebraic structure of this group. So we can introduce a special kind of semi-direct products, which are called rest products. They are well known, but here usually they correspond to so-called effective actions on one group on another group, and we consider this kind of groups. So I take arbitrary group and I take a product of this group to m power of this group, and there is a natural action of z. Of integers on this m's power just by cyclic permutations. And this allows to construct the group structure on this product of sets. It is given by this operation. So we just not in the direct product, we multiply every element with the corresponding element here, but in the semi-direct product, what we do, we first, if we have here L, then here K, then we just make cyclic shift of these elements by k, and after that we multiply them by coordinate wise and add these numbers. Well, and now consider, let P be the minimal set of isomorphism classes of groups which have these properties. So we start from the unit group, and then we can produce arbitrary operation of products of groups and taking rest product of that special kind with arbitrary M. So for example, let me just choose another color. For example, the group of this kind Z, say 3, Z2, Z, Z, Z here I can again take this 5z, then multiply everything by z to the power 3, then again take 17z, and so on. Every these combinations of symbols, if they are correctly written, then they belong to this group. And the statement is that, it should be s of f plus. So consider the subgroup of diffeomorphism which are fixed on the boundary and preserve my function. Then the statement which was proved, I improved this paper several times from this time, and currently it is not published yet, but the general statement is that the pi zero of the stabilizer can be written in the following form. So again, excuse me, pi zero. So this group is embedded into this group, and there is a kernel. We have a kernel with kernel z, and this group is a quotient of this by z, and we need to take some direct product with z two. First of all, so this group has this structure, and this group belongs to the class P. So actually this group is obtained, so it can be written by a formula of almost arbitrary kind of this form. And then there is some Z here, some element here Z. We should take quotient over it and take a semi-direct product with Z2. And this will be the structure of this group. Well, now I have 2 minutes, and let me just say few words why this theorem is true and what are geometrical meaning of this statement. Actually, it is essentially based on the following more general observation. Namely, suppose we have an embedded graph. For example, if I take a function on a disk, this will be a very strange picture, but there is the first level set which is closer to the boundary. And this level set is a graph, some graph embedded in the surface. So the general statement, suppose we have arbitrary connected graph embedded into the surface, which is connected, and what I require only that it has no points of order two. So we have this graph, and the statement is that if suppose I have a diffeomorphism which maps this graph to itself. So this is a diffeomorphism of my disk, and suppose this diffeomorphism reverses orientation of the disk but leaves this graph invariant. Then the statement that is, if I take the square of this diffeomorphism, then it will preserve each edge, the square will fix every vertex and every edge, and preserve the orientation of this edge. So the reason is just, I will finish, but suppose I have picture of this kind, then in fact, if I try to cut my disk along this graph, then I will get something like cylinder. This corresponds to the boundary, and here if I get out these points, vertices of this graph, and cut along edges, then I obtain a cylinder with finitely many points removed from one boundary component. Now I have a homeomorphism H induces a homeomorphism of this cylinder because K remains invariant. And it induces a permutation of these edges. And then H induces a permutation of these edges, and H reverses orientation. So I can look at this as a right n polygon So the word, the edges, for example, corresponds to these segments. And then if H change orientation, then that means that H induces permutation of edges of this polygon. And since it reverses orientation, then its square is the identity. And this means that the square of H should preserve every edge with this orientation. So at least every edge here will be mapped to itself and with preserving orientation. If there is something inside, then since, for instance, we have this picture, and let me draw it in zoom these things. Then we will see that if this edge is invariant, and here in the neighborhood of this point, there is a fixed cyclic order of edges. Then if this edge is fixed, if H square preserves this edge and preserves this point, then it also preserves the next edge, and then the next edge, and so on. And so this can be proved that this implies that all edges will be invariant. And this is the reason why it is true. And actually this theorem with some additional technicalities implies this result. So that's all. Thank you very much.
Okay. Let's thank to the speaker. Any questions?
I have a question. Mm-hmm. Hello?
Yes.
So the graphs appear in this construction. I seem symmetric, yes?
Yes, but they visually are symmetric, but they can be topologically non-asymmetrical. No, maybe there are some topological symmetries in this. So there are homomorphisms. So visually it is not always evident that it is symmetric or not.
But there is non-trivial symmetry of this graph, yes?
But if there is non-trivial symmetry, that actually its square is always the identity. What this is the feature. Because mm-hmm. it is embedded in the surface and its boundary, it is approximated by circles. Because it's regular, the boundary of its regular neighborhood is a circle. What this is the reason.
The next question, the second question, can this result be generalized, for example, no, for torus with one hole, one boundary components, but I think it depends on the fundamental group in this case, yes, non-trivial fundamental groups, a more complicated situation.
Yes, but actually it is possible to reconstruct, but obtain some other. So if you have a homomorphism which reverses orientation, then actually we can prove something existence of another homomorphism which actually has order two. So what this result here can be extended to surfaces of high genus, but we need to make some additional.
But doesn't depend on the fundamental group. There are much more possibilities in this case.
But the question is about reconstruction. So the idea is that if a function admit a homomorphism which has order two in homotopical sense, and this allows to make a construction which.
And the final question is: what about summer school in this year? Is it possible in principle or not?
I don't know. No, maybe it is better to ask Lena Karlova. She wanted to. Okay. At least
thank you. Uh-huh. Very interesting talk. Thank you very much.
Okay. Any more questions?
I have a question.
Yeah. Yes.
You have semi-direct product by Z2. of PZ, pi zero. And the question is following. The structure of this semi-direct product, have you some we have in generally different semi-direct products, and you obtain the questions for do you obtain concretely the semi-direct product or some?
It depends, of course. You see that this semi-direct product is determined by this by a choice of this G. Yeah, this is precisely if you have an element of
but if you have G, you have unique direct product.
If I have G, then I have a section. And if I have a section, it gives me precisely semi-direct product. And this G actually, it can be, since, because I know that this group has a very special structure. So this pi zero with plus, where pi zero with plus, it is a quotient of a group of this kind by special element Z, which is analog of, in Garcide element, Garcide element in braid groups. So this is a special element which rotates everything, and so it is analog of this element. It is presented here, and we take a quotient by it, and then one can also find this is not final result because we only started this era to do this. But actually, I think we will be able to precisely write down the structure of a semi-direct product. So the choice of this element G square, of this element G.
This element G defines direct product, yes?
Yes, it defines direct product. Yeah. It can be, because algebraically we know this. We know what is the structure of this group. Mm-hmm. Then we, no. This element G determines automorphism of this group. Yeah, because by conjugation, automorphism of order two. And actually, it is possible to write down the concrete automorphism. This is our next aim with Ira to understand what automorphisms of order two are induced by orientation reversing homomorphism of surface. What this was the statement.
But the question: if the section G is unique,
no. You see, for example, this. What you look at this?
Up to homotopy, no?
No. Let me see. Well, for example, consider this. Oh, it's just this one. What? You have a homomorphism which is symmetric with respect to this line, and with respect to this line. And they are essentially different.
But the structure semi-direct product is then different, no?
Well, I don't know.
Your group left is depends on on the section.
Sure. This there are many
different decomposition.
Into and this is a standard effect. So many groups can be decomposed into the differently into semi-direct.
Okay, thank you very much. Mm-hmm.